I want to show you how you can use PyVision to build a customized display to monitor your process in just a few minutes with only a web browser. First, I'll go to my machine, @PyVision, go straight to the home page. Now let's imagine this scenario. I'm an engineer. I get a call from my manager and she says, "Hey, I'm getting reports that the pumps at our Philadelphia plant are acting up. Sounds like the bearing temperature is going out of spec. Can you take a quick look and present at our group meeting in 15 minutes? Let me show you how I can use PyVision to prepare for my meeting. The first thing I'll do is click the new display button here. The basic instructions are listed inside the display. If I happen to know the name of my pipe point for the pump, I could enter it inside the search box. But let's pretend I don't. I'm able to navigate to my asset if I have my asset framework structure set up. My manager mentioned that the problem is occurring at the Philadelphia plant, so I'll search for Philadelphia and drill down to my pump. I'll select it, and now I can see all my attributes here. Since it's the bearing temperature that's a problem, I'll choose that, and then using the symbol gallery, I'm going to choose a symbol that will help me visualize it. I have a choice of a trend, a value, a table, three different gauges, as well as an asset comparison table. By default, trend is selected, so all I have to do is drag the bearing temperature inside the display. I'll make it a little bigger, and I'll also add some other process parameters as well, holding the control key. To help my team get a clear picture of what this trend is about, let's add a pump image to customize the display. I can grab a stock graphic in the graphic library here, but I happen to have my own image, so I'll choose the image icon, create a placement area, and browse to my image. Since we know that the bearing temperature is the problem, I want to see it as a vertical gauge to get more visual context. I'll find it again, select it, choose a vertical gauge, and add it to the display. And I'll do the same for the discharge flow rate. But what if I want to change my symbol? All I have to do is right-click it and switch it. And I'm going to switch it to radial gauge. Also add a label. I'll hit the text icon and I'll call my display pump conditions. Change the color to yellow, make it bigger, and place it right here. I can change my duration from 8 hours to 1 hour and go back in time to see how my parameters have been behaving. It's only been a few minutes and I already have the information I need for my meeting. I can figure out when was the last spike in the bearing temperature and what was going on with the flow rate and other parameters at the time. Now I want to provide more context. It's not just time series data that I'm interested in. If I have asset framework, I can view calculated data and maintenance information, so let me add that as well. I'll choose that, select table, and add the table to my display. I'll also add the installation date and the maintenance date. And I'll clean up the table by configuring it. Right-click and remove the columns I don't need. I'll make this column a little bigger by double-clicking the border, adjust this, and now I want to add a name of my asset to visualize it as a value. I'll find it in the attributes pane, choose value, and drag it inside. And I'll do the same for the status of the pump to know if it's on. I'll format the values by right-clicking them, and under visibility I'll remove the label, the units and the timestamp, and change the color of the value to orange. And I'll do the same for this value. I'll simplify the label, remove the units and timestamp, change the text color to orange as well. Now we just customized the values, and we can do the same things for other symbols just by right-clicking them. I'm going to change the label to bearing. And change this one as well. Great. Now let me save my display. You just saw that we exited design mode because the orange frame around the display has disappeared. I can bring it back by going back to the design mode icon. So if I click it, I'm back in design mode. When I exit design mode, there's a lot I can do. I can't move the symbols, but I can do a deeper dive inside my trend. For instance, I can zoom into an area of interest by dragging it. I can also move back in time by selecting the lower section of my trend to see how my process variables have been behaving. I also can add trend cursors by clicking anywhere inside the trend and getting a specific value for each trace at every moment. To remove the cursor, all I have to do is hit Ctrl Z to undo. I'll go back to 8 hours, return to the present moment to see real-time data, and now if I want to, I can also see the process parameters of my other assets by using the asset switch here. So I'll take a look at pump 2 and 3. Great, this display does exactly what I need. This is an awesome dashboard that I created in just a few minutes inside a browser. And now I'm all set for that group meeting with time to spare to grab a coffee.